Today on The Struggling Guitarist, we're going to struggle through Every Rose Has Its Thorn by Poison. I'll see you there. Ooh. So today we're going to be working on Every Rose Has Its Thorn by Poison. This is good stuff. So the thing about this song is it will really show you if you have clean chords and how good your transitions are, because there's not a lot of difficulty to it. I mean, obviously, yes, if you get into the solo, that's got a lot of cool bends, that's got a lot of things. This is pretty darn simple. This is four chords. It is a G, and we're doing the full G here. We've got our pinky and our ring finger on the bottom two strings here, and we're making the full G chord. We're doing a C add 9. You stay in the same position and you move your index and your ring down one string. And make sure to mute this top string. You also have a D. And you have an E minor. And that's it. Those are the four chords that we use all the way through the song. Now, the one thing to be aware of is, yes, it does mix up here and there, but it's really easy. It's just verse one is just slightly different than chorus versus the solo section, but it's basically all the same strums and it's the exact same notes. Anyway, let's get started. So first things first, I need to discuss my guitar setup today. Instead of the standard tuning, I have tuned it down by half of a step. So for example, instead of an E, it's an E flat. Instead of an A, it's an A flat. You get the point, all the way down. So the strum would be like down, 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 up. That's gonna go through about 95% of the song. There's a couple times where we take short breaks, but you know what? Stick with that strum and it works all the way through it. This intro starts on a G. Now, I already explained the strumming pattern. However, the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna break it. For this first one, he actually does an upstroke. Up, down, 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 up, down, 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 up. And it continues on. It's only that very first one. Down. So you're gonna do that on the and a four, and then you're gonna go straight into the normal strums, which start on a one. And one, two, three. So we are gonna do a G twice. We're gonna scoot down to the C add 9, and then it's just. You play that twice through. Then you repeat the whole thing. And like that, congratulations, you're done with this first step. Next, we're on to the verse. And the verse starts out with that exact same progression that we just learned. You're going to do that intro section, I'm doing the quotation marks, twice through. At this point, we're going to go one time through the G, to the C add 9, to the G, to the C add 9, to two Ds in a row, to a C add 9 twice through. Let's do that again. So a G twice through. C add 9 twice through. G twice. C add 9. G. C add 9. G. C add 9, D, C add 9, twice through. And that's the verse. Let's move on. So now we move on to the chorus. And guess what? it starts with that intro section. The G two times, to the C add nine two times, repeat it all, to the G two times, to the C add nine two times, it's the G one time through, to a D, to a C add nine, to a G. At which point we move into the last section, which is a G twice. And here you're gonna hit the C add nine, but you're gonna do one single strum. And it's gonna carry through not only that bar, but the next bar. So let's try all that again. Again. To the G, to the D, to the C add nine, to the G, 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 do 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 ch. And once again, we move on to the next section. Now on to the bridge. The bridge is the only time the song slightly deviates. So the bridge actually starts on the E minor. To a D. To a C add nine. And you could do a G here. I am going to throw in a curveball here. So instead of doing the G for four, I'm actually going to go one, two, and I'm going to move up here to the big E on the second fret, and I'm going to bend it. So let's try that part again by adding that in, right? So it'd be E minor to the D to the C add nine to two Gs to the E minor, to the D, to the C add nine twice. Should I speed it up a little bit, just so we can hear it? Like that. You've learned the bridge. Now I've got solo one and solo two grouped into the same thing. Solo one is, what a surprise, the intro all over again. I know, crazy, right? The good news is that makes our job easy. We can just move on to solo two. Now, what's awesome about solo two is you've learned this already as well. The first half is that intro section, and the second half is just like the bridge with the string bend and everything. To go over solo two, just to make sure we're on the same page, you do the intro twice, right? Again. Then you'd go to the E minor, to the G, to the C add nine, and you're done with the solo sections. So now we go into the soft verse, or the break. What happens is you still have a G and a C add nine. That's the only notes here, but the strumming's a little different. So you're gonna do a down on the first beat. You're gonna do an up, down, up on the and a three, four, and the and a four. So one, two, three, and. But this time, you're gonna go into that C add nine. Remember that C add 9 should be on the first beat. I do jump it and I switch early, or I take my fingers off and I'll get sort of like this open sound. That's not right. Don't do that. Don't do that. The way this should work is it should be down, up, down, up. Switch to a C add 9. Down, up, down, up, down, down, up. And you do that 4 times through. The one part I want to point out is this happens very quickly after the last part. 2, 3, 4. 2, 3. And of course, the next part will be right back on that G. Let's get started. Final verse is once again more of the same stuff you've already seen, but it's just slightly different, so I want to acknowledge it. Instead of the usual intro section, which we play all the way through, this one is a G one time, a C add 9, a G, a C add 9, then 2 Ds, and 2 C add 9s. It's 1 G to a C add 9 to a G. To a C add 9, to 2 Ds, to 2 C add 9. Let's do that whole thing one more time. And then we move on to the next part. Finally, the last section. This section is the outro, but it's only bouncing on this second fret. So at the end, every rose has its thorn. And this section plays. Now, what's happening there is we're gonna play an open on the big E, the 2 on the big E, an open on the A, an open on the D, an open on the big E, and then we just do the G, nice and slow. Let's do it one more time. And you're done with Every Rose Has Its Thorn. Okay, why don't we tackle this song together? Now, while the whole song is a ton of fun to play, I feel it can get pretty repetitive. So this time around, we're basically going to play a greatest hits version from the different sections. So what I have here is the full song in gray and my truncated version next to it. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with a verse 1, with the exception, I'm going to actually play the pickup note like we do in the intro just to get started. It'll sound great. Let's do it. Then we're going to move on to the chorus, followed by the bridge. Then we're going to do the break twice through, back to the verse 2, then the chorus, and finally the outro. Let's get started.
Thank you.
So thanks for helping me struggle through Every Rose Has Its Thorn. Man, great band, great song, and it's a lot of fun. Good campfire strumming here, and you know what? You still can benefit from it. Work on your chords, making them clean. Work on your transitions. I'm not looking at myself or pointing or anything like that. I'm just saying. It's been a lot of fun. I appreciate everything you guys do. Please hit that like and subscribe button. And I'll see you next time on The Struggling Guitarist.